Although rooting and modding of Android devices is somewhat popular, Google has been cracking down recently with their Play Integrity API, which allows apps to block anyone who's using a modified device. In addition, a lot of apps are implementing their own root detection, blocking anyone with any suspicious modifications. But in this video, I'm going to bypass it and fool apps into thinking my rooted device is unmodified. This is my Samsung Galaxy A54 5G. It's my main phone and it's rooted with Magisk, an open source tool that can grant root access to devices systemlessly. For years, if you wanted to root, you'd use Magisk. Created by John Woo, it was perfect. Magisk Hide could hide all mentions of root to Google's root detection and any app you choose. Modules could be installed for deeper modification, and systemless root allowed you to gain root access without inherently modifying the system, which was one thing that the old method, SusFS, couldn't accomplish. But then Google started fighting back. They made SafetyNet, their system against modified devices, stronger. Then they replaced SafetyNet with Play Integrity, which is what's used today. Play Integrity has three different verdicts: Basic, Device, and Strong. Basic indicates that a device passes basic system integrity checks. The bootloader can be locked or unlocked, boot state verified or unverified, or even uncertified by Google Play Protect. For some apps, basic integrity is all you really need, but many will refuse to even open. Device indicates that an app is running on a genuine Play Protect certified Android device. On modern versions of Android, the certification is hardware backed, so it checks for proof that the bootloader is locked and the loaded OS is an official certified image. This is the minimum verdict requirement for most apps, but some apps in particular, like banking apps, are very strict and require the next result. Strong is the highest Play Integrity verdict, and it indicates an app is running on a genuine Play certified Android device that's unmodified. On Android 13 and higher, it requires device integrity and a security update in the last year. On Android 12 and lower, it only requires hardware backed proof of boot integrity, not a recent security update. With all of these checks in place, you'd imagine the rooting and custom ROM community would be forced to revert to stock and lock their bootloader. But as always, they found a bypass. Meet KernelSU, a new kernel-based root solution for modern Android devices. It's kernel-based and runs entirely in kernel mode. Like Magisk, it allows systemless modifications through modules. Most Magisk modules work completely fine with KernelSU, but here's the important part. Because KernelSU runs in kernel mode and hooks root directly into the kernel, it's better at hiding root from apps that don't need it. So right now, I'm going to install KernelSU on my A54. Right now I'm rooted with Magisk. I downloaded a Play Integrity checker, checked my device status, and I was only getting basic. That's not enough. Next, I downloaded the KernelSU app and opened it. At the top, it shows not installed, which means my device has a GKI kernel and is officially supported by KernelSU. If you open the app and it shows unsupported, then you'll need to compile the kernel yourself and integrate KernelSU with it. Check the XDA forums to see if someone has already done this for your device. I clicked to install KernelSU, and since I'm already rooted, it gave me the option for direct install. I clicked next, but it failed, because I was using a Magisk patched boot image. So I opened the Magisk app, clicked uninstall, then clicked restore images. When you install Magisk, it takes a backup of your stock boot image for if you need to uninstall it later. Once I restored the stock boot image, I tried again with the KernelSU direct install, and it worked. It installed KernelSU in LKM mode. I tried rebooting, but then I was stuck on the boot splash. Minutes went by and I was still on the boot splash. The phone would not boot. But then I remembered a crucial piece of documentation from the KernelSU website. KernelSU has two modes for modern devices, which are GKI and LKM. GKI stands for Generic Kernel Image, and if you install it this way, it replaces the original kernel of the device with a GKI provided by KernelSU. LKM stands for Loadable Kernel Module. When you install KernelSU this way, it injects itself into the device kernel without replacing the original kernel. The documentation outlines that Samsung devices with NUX enabled cannot use LKM mode. I only remember this at the last minute. Fortunately, I had other options. I looked in the XDA forums and found a custom kernel for my A54 going by the name of Squeak Kernel, created by Vaz15K. It disables some NUX stuff, includes small optimizations, and most importantly, includes KernelSU. I downloaded the GKI version and flashed it to my phone through a custom recovery, Orange Fox. Next, I rebooted my phone and crossed my fingers. The phone moved on from the boot splash and started booting. My phone booted successfully and I opened the Magisk app. It showed that it wasn't installed. Then I opened the KernelSU app. It was successfully installed in GKI mode. KernelSU also doesn't expose the SU binary to apps that don't require it. You can see here as I try to check for root and it instantly denies and says this device is not rooting. I had to go into the KernelSU app and allow root checker root access manually. This is great because apps that refuse to work on rooted devices can't find the SU binary and lock you out due to its existence. Anyway, let's continue. I checked the modules section and it even transferred over my Magisk modules. But these modules I have for play integrity are outdated, which is why I was only getting basic integrity earlier. So now I'm going to show you what I use to get a better verdict. I downloaded Zygis Next, Play Integrity Fork, and Tricky Store. Zygis Next is a replacement for Zygisk, Magisk's built-in tool to inject code into apps. Since KernelSU doesn't have it built-in, we use Zygis Next. Play Integrity Fork allows a rooted device to cosplay as another one to Google services so that they can't detect if your device is modified. Tricky Store contains key boxes, which are essentially a certificate that proves your device has a locked bootloader and is using official software. Using these key boxes, you can spoof the device's status. The coolest thing about Tricky Store is that key boxes can be replaced remotely. Google revokes key boxes, which makes you unable to pass play integrity. But Tricky Store can give you a new one and you'll be able to get a good verdict again. I installed all the modules, then rebooted my phone. When I checked play integrity, I was failing all three checks and I couldn't even get basic integrity. But then I realized I forgot to do the extra steps. The first step was clicking the action button on play integrity fork, which generates props and a fingerprint of a known good device, in my case a Pixel 6 Beta. Next, I opened the web UI for Tricky Store, selected all apps, then set a valid key box. Now when I check play integrity, it returns strong, which is the highest verdict you're able to get. For all Google knows, my phone is completely stuck and unmodified. Now we have to address the elephant in the room, which is root hiding. I downloaded some banking apps and opened them. They brought me to their sign-in screen without complaining that I'm rooted, but to me, that wasn't enough. Now I'll introduce you to KernelSU Next and SusFS. KernelSU Next is a modified version of KernelSU with more updates and a better looking manager. And SusFS, that is the game changer. It's a service that interfaces with a special kernel to hide all traces of root in the file system at a kernel level. But the catch is, you need a SusFS patched kernel. The one I used earlier, Squeak Kernel, wasn't patched with SusFS. So I did some digging and found Dog Kernel, a kernel for the Galaxy A54 created by Dog Laro Glue. There are a lot of different variants, but I downloaded the one that included KernelSU Next and was patched with SusFS. So I rebooted my phone to recovery mode, backed up my boot and init boot partitions just in case, flashed the kernel, then rebooted. When I was booting into Android, the live boot output appeared, which meant I still had root access, so the kernel migration probably worked. As I reached the lock screen, I got a message saying there was an internal problem with my device, but I decided to ignore it. I opened the KernelSU app and it showed not installed, meaning vanilla KernelSU was removed. Then, when I opened the KernelSU Next app, it showed that it was installed and working in GKI mode. Not only that, also showed the SusFS version, confirming the kernel is patched with it. In order to fully utilize SusFS, you need a special module that interfaces with the kernel. This module will not work on a kernel that's not patched with SusFS. Check XDA forums or Telegram for a SusFS patched custom kernel for your device. I installed the SusFS for KernelSU module, then rebooted my phone. Now I could open the web UI interface. There are several extra options for hiding stuff like Google Apps and YouTube Rewinds, but the default configuration is enough for most people. I can now install any app on this phone, and they'll have zero reason to suspect that my phone is rooted or modified. I can play games, use banking apps, and anything I want without getting locked out due to root. If you made it this far, that means you enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you liked it, leave a dislike if you dislike it, comment your thoughts, and subscribe below to the channel. Thanks for watching.